Hello and welcome. Suppose I have the surd 1 divided by 2 root 5 minus root 3. And I note that the square root of 5 and the square root of 3 are both irrational numbers, which means I can't calculate them to a certain decimal place, and they can't be expressed as a fraction of two whole numbers. So I don't really like the way that this surd is written, and I want to rationalize the denominator. So turn what's on the bottom into a rational number. The only way that I can get rid of these radicals or these square roots is to square these terms. And to do that, I'll need some help from algebra. You may recall from algebra that if I have a plus b multiplied by a minus b, if I was to distribute this out, I would end up with a squared minus b squared. This is what is called the difference of two squares, and it's a pretty easy and handy rule or algebraic identity to remember. So in this case, I'm going to treat 2 root 5 as my a term, and I'm going to treat square root of 3 as my b term. So I'm going to multiply this denominator by this denominator of 2 square root 5 minus square root 3. I'm going to multiply this denominator by 2 root 5 plus root 3. But as always with fractions, if I multiply the bottom by 2 root 5 plus root 3, I'm also going to have to multiply the top by 2 square root 5 plus root 3. So effectively, I'm multiplying this expression by 1. Okay. Okay, so if I carry out this calculation, I will get 2 times the square root of 5 all squared minus root 3 squared, and on the top I'll end up with 2 times root 5 plus root 3. Now all there's to do is to evaluate the terms on the bottom. So the 2 square root 5 plus root 3 remain on the top, divided by 2 times the power of 2 to the power of 2 multiplied by root 5 squared, and the square root 3 squared simply evaluates to 3. Note that I've applied my index law here, where I can just expand the index into the parentheses. So I end up with 2 root 5 plus root 3 divided by 4 times 5 minus 3. And 4 times 5 is 20 minus 3 is 17. And that's how you would rationalize the denominator of a surd. If you found this video useful, please give me a thumbs up. If you are currently studying math, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for future videos that may help you on exams or assignments. And as always, please feel free to ask me any question by commenting on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you've learned something.